Good morning, dear students. So, welcome to the class of biology, and we were studying about the particular chapter nutrition. So, what we have already studied till now. Just recapping the things: what are nutrients, what is food, what is appetite, what is hunger, then what are the six classes of food that we eat, the carbohydrate, fat, vitamins, minerals, water, and proteins. We have already learned through this what are the things, how they are available in us, what are the deficiency diseases. Also, I have given you a task to remember the particular two tables that are present in your book. I hope you all have went through that particular all the things. So also, I know that you all have asked me your queries that you have in your mind or that was going on during this particular video lecture. So very well done with that. Keep going like this. We'll be continuing with the only small part left in your chapter. We'll be continuing with the particular balanced diet. Okay, now for balanced diet, see, there is a table 10.4. okay, we are following Concepts Biology class 9. Chapter is chapter number 10, page number 101. Okay, please open that, students. So see, importance of cellulose in our diet. What is this? Cellulose constitutes the roughage in our food. Roughage is the undigestible portion in the diet. The fruits, vegetables, and the outer coating of the seeds and grains, example choker of wheat flour, are particularly rich in roughage. The roughage enables the food to move easily through the intestine. It stimulates secretions from the digestive tract and helps in the removal of the cholesterol or the fatty excretory substance and toxins. Constipations can often be avoided by including sufficient roughage in the food. Salad, green vegetables, whole fruits such as guava along with its seeds are not only nutritious but also they provide roughage. So roughage is very much important. If you do not consume roughage, or you say no, I don't like roughage and all, so don't do that. Please start taking roughage in your particular day-to-day meal or day-to-day lifestyle. Okay, so we will be studying about what is balanced diet. We all know what is balanced diet, yet please follow your book. A balanced diet is one which contains all the principal constituents of food in proper quantity. One special aspect of balanced diet is the sufficient number of calories which it will provide. So balanced diet is the one which contains all the principal constituents of the food in proper quantity. So see, if it happens, for example, what you all do is you will go to shop, buy a egg roll, okay, or you go to a shop, food stall, and buy a burger or a pizza. Now what happened with that? You are taking pizzas or you are taking burgers or you are taking a particular chicken roll or egg roll. Now what happens, some of these pizzas, burgers and all, these are all junk food. So what is a junk food? Okay, see, junk food is nothing but it contains more amount of carbohydrates. Okay, now whenever there will be more amount of carbohydrates and fats that we are consuming in our body, it gets stored in the body. Okay, now this provides a harmful effect in our body. We get fat, we get overweight, we have certain problems in our body, our heart stops functioning properly, and these all things happen. So it is very important to have a balanced diet. Also, we know that if a particular nutrient is absent from our body for a prolonged time, for example, protein is absent for our body for a prolonged time, what happened? We have already learned about the particular two type of diseases, right? So this is very much important, my dear students, to understand the need of proper balanced diet. Now you will be questioning me, sir, what is balanced diet or how much amount do we need to take? Now we have already went to that, what are the four types which depends, or what are the four classification which depends what type of food we need to consume. It depends on our age, it depends on everything. Anyway, our special aspects of balanced diet is the sufficient number of calories which it will provide. So how much calorie आई ड्रेन एवरी डे डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ मच कैलोरी वी नीड टू कंज्यूम और आई नीड टू कंज्यूम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सी फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग टिल नाइट आई एम टेकिंग क्लासेज ऑफ यू ऑल स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम क्लास 6 टू क्लास 10 देन ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स टेकिंग पेपर्स ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सी दिस इज अ लॉकडाउन सिनेरियो सो आई एम स्टेइंग इन होम. बट इफ इट वुड हैव बीन अ ऑफलाइन सिनेरियो देन आई नीड टू वेंट टू स्कूल आई नीड टू इंटरेक्ट विद यू ऑल आई नीड टू रोम अराउंड योर स्कूल आई नीड टू गो फ्रॉम माई हाउस टू योर स्कूल इट इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस. सो वॉट हैपन्स the energy cost of my particular body would have been more, right? So there I see if suppose thousands of the energy or thousands of the calories are being drained away from my body at the end of the day, then on the very next day or on that particular day I need at least 1000 calories of energy in our body. It can be 1000, 10,000, 20, but at least 1000 in my body so that it can get replenished and I can work or my body can work properly. Am I clear to you all? Same goes for you all as well. For your particular functioning, you are like whatever you are doing, you are playing, you are studying, you are waking up in the morning, going to sleep at night, having food. So if you do not have food, what happens? Your energy gets drained away. Okay. So our special aspect of a balanced diet is the sufficient number of calories which it will provide. A calorie is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree centigrade. So, how do we define calorie? This is very important. Please have a look. This, I guess, we have already learned in physics, yet a calorie is the amount of heat. It is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree centigrade. Okay. So what is it? A calorie can be defined as the amount of heat that is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree centigrade. Now we are taking only 1 gram of water and we are raising its temperature by 1 degree centigrade. So the amount of heat that I need to give to raise that particular temperature is known as 1 calorie. Okay. One is, what is 1 kilocalorie? 1 kilocalorie is 1000 calorie. Okay, we all know gram and calorie, gram and kilograms relation, it is related as 1000. Same goes for here also. 1 kilocalorie is 1 by 1000, 1 kilocalorie is 1000 calories. Okay. If the daily intake of food does not provide sufficient calorie, a person loses weight as it rapidly happens during fasting. In that situation, the existing food stores the body are oxidized and the capacity of work is reduced. So, we all know this, right? Now, what is malnutrition? Malnutrition is the condition in which a person suffers due to lack of deficiency of one or more essential elements of food. So, when it is a condition in which a person suffers, okay, that person gets diseased or get affected or ill due to lack of deficiency of one or more essential elements of food. Now this completes a particular chapter, nutrition and a balanced diet menu for an adult doing moderate physical work, 10.4. It is here, you can go through it. This is not very much important, yet questions can come. It is better you just go through it, no need to learn this particular thing, yet you just go through it, okay. And other rest tables which I have already told you, that is very much important. So please try and learn this chapter very carefully. I have completed this chapter, nutrition, as per Conscience Biology ICSC class 9, and I hope you all have no problem in this particular chapter. for any of the particular questions or queries that you are arising, please do feel free to text me or to mail us or to contact in any of the given mail IDs or numbers. But please do study. This is the online scenario going on, global pandemic going on outside us. We are all staying in home, we are locked down in a lockdown condition. So all of you, please try to study. The particular chapter nutrition is being completed. The question answers and inside questions I will be definitely providing in the class. Don't worry about that. But please do study and try to understand whatever I have taught you all. Okay. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay happy. Stay in your house. Wear a mask. Use sanitizer. Take care of your parents. Take care of your family. Have a good day. Thank you.